On to more news, Philippine aviation authorities assure the public there will be no more air traffic fiasco after the upcoming maintenance shutdown next week. Our correspondent Job Manahan is on the line for more. Job?
Denise, good afternoon. The public may expect no more air traffic fiasco in the near future after the maintenance activities of the Civil Aviation Authority of the Philippines, or CAAP's air traffic management system, slated next week. The CAAP on May 17 will replace the air traffic management system's uninterruptible power supply, or UPS, that faltered on New Year's Day. In relation to it, the Philippine airspace will be shut down for 2 hours on that day, or between 2 a.m. and 4 a.m. When asked whether the maintenance would prevent similar incidents from happening in the future, CAAP spokesperson Eric Apolonio answered in the affirmative. The May 17 activities from CAAP will be the last phase of their maintenance, which includes the upgrade of their air traffic management system. Let's hear what he has to say.
Dito sa CNSATF, yun na po, mataas yung porsyento na wala nang mangyayari. Dahil unang-una, meron tayong reserve na UPS. Besides yung original maintenance provider, ho, naibalik na natin. Kaya medyo alam na nilang gagawin just in case magkaroon ng problema. Nagkaroon po tayo ng backup system na UPS. Meaning, kung sakaling magkaroon ng failure, easy switch on ito agad yun. Kaya nababaan natin from 12 to 6, ginawa na ho natin 2 to 4 na lang yung maintenance activity.
The Manila International Airport Authority earlier said that the shutdown will affect flights at the Ninoy Aquino International Airport, Clark International Airport, and Mactan Cebu International Airport, and several flights of the other 42 CAAP commercially operated airports. Last January 1, it can be remembered that the Air Traffic Management Center, which controls inbound and outbound flights, went down due to a power outage, which resulted in the loss of communication, radio, radar, and internet. This forced hundreds of flights to be canceled, delayed, or diverted, affecting over 65,000 passengers. Denise?
Thanks, Job.
A sweeping suspension slapped by the Kuwaiti government on all types of visas for Filipinos. A government circular seen by ABS-CBN News said only Filipinos with valid residence permits will be allowed entry into the Gulf state. The suspension reportedly came after Kuwait accused Manila of violations in their labor deal. But the Arab country's move came after Manila suspended its deployment of first-time workers to Kuwait. That decision was a result of the brutal murder of Filipino domestic worker Julie B. Ranara, allegedly in the hands of her employer's son in January. The Philippines has said then it will review its labor deal with Kuwait.
The Philippine Energy Department says yellow alerts could be raised in Luzon over the next few weeks due to thin power supply. A yellow alert means power reserves are below ideal levels. The agency notes it is currently banking on the Ilihan power plant in Batangas to help stabilize the current power supply in Luzon.
Inaasahan po natin pagdating ng May 26 ay mag-ooperate na po siya at magbabato na po ng kuryente sa ating grid. Inaasahan po nating 1,200 megawatts ang makokontribute nito sa ating power supply at napakalaking bagay po niyan. Pag umandar po ang Ilihan sa May, baka po yung iba nating posibleng yellow alerts sa June ay ma-avoid na po natin.